If I asked you what gravity is, I think you'd answer along the lines of, it's what's keeping us on the ground, or it's what allows our planets to orbit the sun, or something like, it's what Isaac Newton discovered way back when with an apple and a mild concussion. And while those are all true, gravity itself is when massive objects bend reality or space-time around them. And if something can bend, why can't it wiggle? So, let me introduce to you something called gravity waves. And no, gravity is not waving at you. Gravity waves are ripples in space-time. Like the waves in the ocean or a rock dropped into a still pond. They are pure energy traveling at the speed of light away from massive accelerating objects. Okay, let's break that down a little bit. This here black hole, let's call him Bill Hader. And this one here, let's call her Barbara Hale. Now, Barbara and Bill are just two black holes orbiting each other. I know, it's crazy, right? Well, contrary to rumor, black holes don't just suck up everything nearby. And as Barbara and Bill here orbit each other, they begin to emit energy. Now, this energy is actually ripples in the fabric of reality extending outwards from these two black holes. These are called gravity waves. As these gravity waves shoot out from Barbara and Bill, the two begin to lose energy and draw closer to one another. And as they get closer and closer, these waves shoot out more and more, steadily drawing them nearer and nearer until BAM! Barbara and Bill merge into one black hole. And since it's no longer accelerating, it's no longer giving off any gravity waves. That's a specific example of gravity waves, but what if we wanted to talk more generally for a second? Well, gravity waves were hypothesized by Albert Einstein, the one and only, in his theory of general relativity. He predicted that when massive objects were accelerating, they would disrupt reality around them, creating ripples. It's like if I put a stick into a bowl of water. If it just sits there, nothing will happen. But as soon as I start to swirl it in a circle, the water becomes disrupted. So, the obvious question is, well, why don't we feel these gravity waves? Especially since the Earth is orbiting the Sun, shouldn't we be producing gravity waves and feeling them? And the answer is yes! Kinda. Okay, I'll explain. The Earth produces gravity waves. However, because our collective mass is so small, our gravity waves are almost nothing. The ones scientists have been able to detect are from black holes millions or even billions of light years away that have just merged, producing incredibly strong waves. But by the time they reach us, they are so small that we can't even feel them, but they can still be measured. So, each time we detect gravity waves here on Earth, that means some Bill and Barbara out there have happily merged into a new black hole. And if we want to get even more technical for a second, the gravity waves in 2015 that made headlines as the first gravity waves ever detected were 1,000 times smaller than the nucleus of an atom. And in contrast, the merging black holes that produced that tiny wave of gravitational energy were each around 30 times the mass of our sun. So, only the most massive objects, like black holes or super dense collections of neutrons called neutron stars, have even the chance to radiate energy all the way out to our tiny planet. What's the takeaway? Gravity waves are energy ripples in the fabric of reality sent when objects accelerate. When two black holes merge, that just so happens to be strong enough ripples for us to detect, proving one part of Einstein's theory of relativity. That's a mouthful, but just wait for trivia night to whip out that tidbit. But at least for now, that's all, folks. Check the link in the description to learn more about how these gravity waves are detected through an awesome machine called an interferometer. And please like and subscribe for more. Comment below which topic you'd like me to explain next.